There is some work that we're doing to effectively hold a centralised database, so an API, effectively all the class names that can then all the different scoring programs can call down, and then when they report back, they're effectively reporting back.
Get Great Lakes to call them the same as well.
Well, yes, but we've got exactly the same problem there, Peter, and even we can't agree.
Well, which from us as a club point of view, with the Grafham Grand Prix on its way up, it's just quite difficult.
Well, it is, yes, and we have a fudge this year, as you may know, but we shouldn't really. We should all be working off the same tables. But we're getting there slowly, but it's the problem is there are so many, there's 300 classes, that's the first problem. Then there's about 300 variants of each class. So
it shouldn't be on.
No, it's not beyond the wit of the people.
The first time a new boat comes along, it would be great if somebody somewhere could say, right, this is what we're going to call it.
Yeah. Well, that's got to be the RA, isn't it? Well, the leadership has to come from our government.
Okay, great, that one.
It would be useful, all I'm saying, is that it came from somewhere.
Yeah.
I mean, the only thing that Sailwave can actually use sort of and is used sort of around the world is the ISAF ID. Mm-hmm. I mean, anybody can get an ISAF ID. It doesn't cost you any money, so you can actually anybody could.
As an individual.
You get an ISAF ID, which is then unique to you.
They have done quite a lot of work this recently.
They have been cleaning it up so that people that have actually.
So I think we know what needs to be done, and I think the fact that some of the key people in this room actually, to be honest, we could solve it tonight if we all got together. So
it would help us at club level.
Oh yeah, no, we fully agree.
So you'd welcome being forced into frameworks.
Yeah. I mean, there are some designs that cause problems. Like we've got a. There's an Acra 17 that's actually sometimes called the Inter 17.
There's a new Sprint I found from Bob the other day.
There's various things where the manufacturers don't help.
They don't know either.
But again, if there was something a bit like ISO, just like barcoding, it's kind of centrally.
Yeah, centrally managed, isn't it? Yeah.
It doesn't have to be an overhead, it could actually be a simplification.
So I think we all understand it, but I think that there are things that can be done at individual level as well, but I think it's a mixture of sort of top-down, centralised and things like that.
Question, in your software, could you put in exception rules to actually check things such as similarities? To stop things like RS Vario?
We do some of that, so when you submit the returns, it does try and work out different things like that, but there's always things that fall through them.
And then things change, like that used to be a laser 2000, now it's just a 2000.
Yeah, the darts, and I mean, laser have a lot to answer for because we keep changing all their names. But
again, if we could go to somewhere and say, right, with effect from 1st of January 2014, everything that was laser 2000 is now going to be called 2000.
2000, yes. Mm-hmm.
And then we'll get a better idea of what we're doing.
I may have missed something in Sailwell. I do think it's a brilliant program and fantastic that it exists for all of us. But in response to a Sport England grant a couple of years ago, I remember downloading the results individually for each series into an Excel spreadsheet, and then downloading all the data I had about which of our members had been involved in running our training program, and then downloading some other data about members that had taken part. I counted up every Tuesday and every Thursday that I'd come down to the club, and managed to put all of that together in a big spreadsheet and try to figure out something useful to say to Sport England in response to what we were doing. And I just would, if I missed on Sailwave a function to be able to download, how often did Joe Smith sail this year? How many races did he sail enough to count in a series? And just generally overall. I remember some delicately framed wording from our race results in the corner about how often I was going to be able to ask him for this information this year. It doesn't seem obvious how to get it out. In that way, when you're trying to sort of monitor participation of particular individuals or across the board, I don't know if we've missed something at all.
Can I just add to that question, which is to say, we try and report on boats and sailors. Okay? Sailwave's pretty good on boats, but actually for a mixed handicap fleet, I've got to go through all the time and add up sailors.
Yeah.
So to actually have a kind of summary report from a series that says, this means you had 462 boat sessions and 730 sailor sessions in that series, actually means I can fill the form in really quickly. And the data's all there, because I just have to do it in my head.
Yeah.
But if you could...
I mean, the biggest problem is actually, like that, I mean, Sailway works on... Each file is either an event or a series.
Mm-hmm.
So what you're really looking to do is produce, when you're producing these statistics, you're going to want to really base them off as a series.
That's what we're doing here. So this is coming from the Sailway data that's in the RAA database.
Yeah, but I just want it for the club.
Yeah, but we can do that.
You draw down at the club.
We haven't, this is not released.
Right,
but, okay. And then there's some discussions that need to happen with people like Duncan. But Sailway is not really a database.
No.
So that we are aggregating data for other reasons, and there's no reason why we can't drill down to that level to give you as the club. And it doesn't have to be Sailway. I mean, you know, and there are other software available and things like that, spreadsheets, and we can take duties in. So I think it exists beyond the actual programs themselves and aggregating them together. But what we've shown is we can do it, and you know, we'll release this sort of during next year as a sort of software alliance product.
Yeah. Having said that, with Medusa, one of the, I think for us, the good things with Medusa, lots of good things, but one of the good things is an output to an Excel file, because then we can just do our sorts by whatever we want.
You can take Sailway straight into an Excel file.
Okay, maybe it's just need to learn how to do it.
It does take quite a lot of manual information. You've got to download them into each one, and then
you can take the whole thing and just put it into one spreadsheet. I'll show you the data afterwards.
For example, if you have spring, summer, and
if you've got separate series,
four races each.
Yeah.
You can actually combine those very simply through your program.
The actual
in a 1672 race.
Yeah, you could do. Yes. I mean, the actual one of the changes in 2.17, which I don't know what versions you're actually on, but I mean that's actually greatly improved the merging. So that's actually got a lot more facilities to do merging of series.
But then all that does, again, is create a longer series.
Yeah.
But I still can't really do this reporting then, we're all talking about today.
Well, you can take that, what you can see on the screen there, that whole spread, that whole table, you can take that on lump and put it into Excel and
right.
Do what you like.
So we're using another software package to do the reporting.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just looking at Sail Racer here, because I know that I've actually uploaded those three main series of handicap races, because we run pursuit races here as well. So none of that's gone anything where the PY numbers are being, I presume the return is for the calculation of PYs for next year.
Correct.
None of those pursuit races get put up there. But are we saying that you are thinking
Sail Racer
might become this manipulation tool for all the sail wave results of different races, different sort
of
series
results
that we've got.
Don't have to be sail wave,
for a particular club. And
yeah,
you
basically. And also, we're doing some work with, you know, like Duty Man, so you can throw your duties in here, you can throw your membership. So this potentially is not going to be a sail race at all, it's going to be a software saving alliance tool that merges everything that potentially everyone's doing into one dashboard that you as a club could dip in and say that, you know, you've done 10 duties or 5 races or whatever, and start to get some really interesting things. Because the reality is you can do this in all the software really, and Medusa can do it and Sailway can do it, but actually the power is if we all combine it together in terms of one really powerful management dashboard tool that takes all the different sources.
They can do it up to a point, and this is again going back to the Commodore's perspective, is that you can then spend all that non-sailing time, which I've run
crunching the data.
Doing the
information
to report back to the RAA.
So there's a lot of data already been used. You know, we're already doing membership. I mean, I guess we're all converted here, aren't we? But people are doing duties, membership, results, everything's happening. But what we're talking about, the next logical step, is that's why, in a way, one of the key remits of the alliance is work together to sort of have that integration, and then effectively sit there on Sunday afternoon and press the button, and you can see a pretty, you know, good snapshot of your club. Now then.
I mean, there is the small issue of how this gets paid for, and how we just by the resource that goes in. But yeah, the principle is we gather all the data from all the systems we've got from all the clubs in the country.
So club dashboard.
Together, we can give an aggregated picture to the RBA for their business, and we can let each of you drill down to have a look at what happened with yours.
Where are we at with that?
Well, we're working. It's already working because we're collecting millions of sales results already. We're doing some work now with Dutyman to take that in. There's no reason why the sale. We've created the principle of data transfer. I mean, to be honest, it's taken 5 years, really. I guess I was enjoying a few headaches, and we're still not there completely. But we now have the principle of transferring data between different software. We can already do it with results and say this is not just Sailweb. That's not Sailweb data. That could be spreadsheets or it could be anything. And we've got people writing their own programs and they just send XML files to us and things like that. Did some work now, duty man to get it. We'll be launching this in time for the next season. it's already here. just need some sort of joining the dots and things like that. Sign up now. But it'll be free to people using our software. I think that's the principle we're coming to.
Yeah, if you're how we'll probably work it.
Probably going to be, if you're using one of the members' software, you'll get this. So yes, it is free.
Can we as a club put in information into that database that is non-racing and non-duty man type information?
Yeah, we're already collecting things like that. I mean, we've got people using our systems to book meals and courses, as you said. So if we've got the data in there, and part of this learning lesson is, and we have talked about what is a session, and is a session, someone propping up for the bar or pulling the pumps or whatever,
But for example, some are already sucking in data off the membership system. So if you wanted to create custom fields about your members, that they went for recreational sale or they spent this much time in the bar, whatever you wanted to put in there about your members would get sucked up.
Yeah. And it comes back to what are we trying to report? I mean, it comes back to what is the answer and what's the question? And then the system's going there. In a way, the systems are there and they're talking to each other, reporting, where do we want to take it? Is the answer here? Do we want to report every session? that's probably one of the fundamental questions. Or then if we do, what questions do we want to answer?
So you just mentioned that you could book courses, book meals, whatever.
Yeah.
So then how do you go about paying for that? So if somebody was...
We run credit card. I think everyone here runs credit card. We process about £1 million of credit cards every year. So
then our club would use your facility... PayPal, whatever.
Well, potentially, yeah. I mean, we already do that for a lot of clubs, and I think Jeremy is, you're doing credit card processing.
Yeah.
I think we're all doing that.
Just to cut, a typical membership system that's taking payments from your members for you, we wouldn't actually handle the money because you get into a lot of.
Well, that's what I'm trying to get at.
That's a lot of different.
But we can run it around your PayPal account. So we run.
We do nothing electronically at the moment.
Right. Okay. So which club are you?
Banbury.
Right. Okay.
And we're looking at moving there at some point very soon.
Yeah.
So and we're going through this whole thought process about online payment, PayPal. How do you do that? Yeah. The security of that, which is why I was wondering when you said that.
Yeah.
Would a third party use your PayPal account?
Use our systems, but it talks to your PayPal account. Yeah. So you're getting the money, but you're using our systems to process it. But the key thing is the data's in here, the money's in your bank account.
Is that
Sale Racer or is that something
else?
It's running on our servers and things like that, but that's sort of almost because we've got servers that are running lots of other things and aggregating it together. But what the alliance is about is all working together and pooling data, pooling resources and system like that. So this will probably be a software sailing alliance product that effectively, we are offering as a group because you're our customers using one of our software.
Yeah.
I mean, I think that's the power of this group, and I think it's, in a way, significant you've got that group. And I've been in the computer industry, and I guess some people in this room have already been in there, and to get that level of tie-up is, if you think about Apple and Microsoft, it doesn't happen that much.
But we're not quite that mighty.
Some of us have ambitions, John. But I think again we're all passionate about the sport and things like that, so that's why we're sitting here at 8 o'clock, a long way from home and things like that. So this is all happening. I think what the proposition is, you can get all your payments and things like that, but potentially get a lot of this data, which clearly I think there's a hunger for and need for.
So that database that you're running there, you're doing on the back of the results collection?
Well, effectively, well, and entries and things like that. So we're running lots of databases. But yeah, the big one for this sort of thing is effectively the results database, which is PY and One Design sort of thing. So it's not just handy. We're not just collecting handicap data. We've got lots of world championships and national championships in our data, you know, things like that. But for, results are easy to collect in a way, as I think we've said many times tonight.
Sorry, we run this locally on our little user and sailor system.
Well, it's in the cloud. Yeah. So it's on website.
All goes into the cloud.
Yeah, yeah. So whatever of our systems you're using, you'll be populating them one way or another with various data. Yeah. And all of our systems are migrating towards having the data in the cloud. So what happens is, Simon's proposal here comes into all those cloud databases.
Okay. So you're talking to a centralised server, you know, you can be on your mobile phone and tablet, you can be in the middle of the water, assuming you get a 3G connection, which I don't think I got here, but you know, you've got Wi-Fi. So you could be in the box and, you know, you're seeing some of this data
being collected. The only kind of extra bit of work you might want to do is, you know, adding some fields about what you record about your members or about your sailing systems, so that we can suck them off.
Part of that is trying to learn, you know, what everyone wants.
Yeah.
You know, we can do it. And we are doing it, we just need to get a feel of what you're trying to output.
I mean, to be honest, it sounds absolutely excellent. Yeah. The only thing I would say is two things. One is defining by the RIA what you actually want.
Yeah.
And make sure these guys can produce it from these things.
Yeah. Click on the button.
And then don't change it.
Yeah.
And the other thing is, if you want participation of people going on the water rather than racing, then we need some level of other entry system.
Yeah, an agreement how that's
captured. So it goes into that.
Yeah, definitely.
So those are the two missing.
And we've got all sorts of ideas, but none of which are perfect. Yeah.
But that's what we want. Do you have to have that? Well, that's because at the moment here, the SSA are working together, and John's leading this campaign for a cloud-based solution, and we can now capture really good membership data. In that membership data, you could actually have all the boats and the PYs and everything uploaded automatically. That would then feed Sailwave or Sailracer automatically, because it's all integrated. Wouldn't need to worry about names, because in my membership database, I've got Andy as Andy, I've got Andrew as Andrew, so it gets rid of all of your issues. And as a sailing software alliance, you're all working together to deliver that. That's excellent. From these reports, which are based on racing events, duty map. And duty manifest, say this is power boat 2 course or safety boat or whatever that training course is, have all of that in there as well. From that information, Duncan, can and we understand why the RIA needs the reporting, can you get agreement that would suffice for the RIA's reporting? Because if you can, then actually we've nailed it.
There's not a simple answer. I mean, for me personally, this whole process is about making us all as intelligent as possible. So, for example, there must be a sweet spot where most of our sailing clubs run their racing in series.
Yeah.
And if your series is too long, with too, let's say, too high a threshold around the number of discards, for example, at some point there's a disincentive to, well, there's no point coming on Sunday the 4th of May because I can't qualify for that series anyway.
Right.
So it should be things like, we're looking at the information in order to go, well, actually, if we run a series of 7 weekends with four weekends to count, then that gets more people racing.
But do you if you're measuring racing, All of the clubs will have different length series, and you'll get all of that information. Yeah. You just need someone to cut the data.
So what I'm saying is, that's an example of, we need to choose the information that will make us as intelligent as we possibly can be.
These guys are going to be everything.
Deliver the activity.
Information about the series and everything else be part of the RIA club survey, because everybody knows that information at the start of the year. Let you have that information.
I think it'd be too onerous, to be honest, in that format.
What series they're running and how many need to count?
Yeah, I think that would be significant. But in terms of the politics of this, so if you like the statutory reporting, at the moment the position that the sport's in is it's very reliant on the Sport England Active People Survey, and the outcomes of that we live and die by. So the investment that goes into the sport, whether it's the OAA or, sure. or the facilities, because we have had a void of previous data other than the racing data. So we've had, since the Portsmouth Yardstick stuff has been harvested online, which has been a slow burn. I don't know what the percentage is now, but
well, I think we've only got 150 clubs, so we must yeah. be, I mean, there must be a good 700 clubs racing, aren't there?
Yeah. So in the absence of that, we didn't do as well as we might have done in this cycle in terms of investment, because we don't have the data to challenge the government statistics. What will happen in the future? I mean, all bets are off, to be honest. We've got a general election in May. It does have a big impact on the politics of this is all what the government requires, and sports trying to make its case as effectively as possible to maintain investment. But very little of this is submitted to Sport England. We don't, to a certain extent, depending on how the statistics are, we don't know what we'll use to defend our corner in the future.
And we understand why you want reporting, but it isn't fair to ask for clubs for all of the information in the world just so you can filter it down and give a little bit.
So my primary motivation is making you and us more intelligent.
My question is John and the SSA getting you enough intelligence for us to hit the button and give you this data automatically so I don't have to stand there with a flip chart and a clipboard counting people as they go on the water on a Sunday afternoon?
I don't know the answer to that question.
The answer is possibly not yet, but we're making strides.
This is kind of why we're here.
We need to know what you want so that we can provide it.
Part of my understanding is walking.
We'll do it.
Surely we've got two different things going on here. We've got clubs that are coming because they are interested in software to make the running of the club better, more streamlined, all those nice things you said at the front. But the conversation is now totally about reporting for the RYA statistics. Isn't it? So there's two things. There's maybe you guys, the RYA and the software people, need to get together, as you say, and say, this is the information that we want from the same community.
But the clubs need to be able to provide that information.
Yes, but
actually,
then
Duncan would like to say, I'd like to record all free sailing sessions. And I get that, and I understand that, but I don't know how I can deliver that and give that. And if we're going to have to do that manually, actually, it almost negates the benefit of putting all of our time and effort into all the other.
Yeah, but it needs to be a two-pronged thing. So you make this nice software for the clubs, and then the RYA come in and say, actually, we need to get this information. So if you bolt that onto the back of that nice package you've got for all the clubs to make their life easier, a click of the button, and it fills it in. And that could change year on year, because you could send out an update when the questions change or the data you want is different.
So where we're at is, our regional development officers and our sailing development officers are running conferences and workshops over the course of the winter. So most of them have done one or two of a series of three by now. But they are asking consistent questions to the clubs to come back so we can review and say, because some of the clubs have actually found some of the questions quite useful or being challenging. So I don't have, at the moment, it's kind of not about me. They're not asking people things that they can't deliver. So we're waiting until we've got a consistent response from all of our clubs, and then we'll review what was asked, and then we'll, on the basis of the feedback that we've had, we'll come up with the most pertinent questions for you and us. Mm. But I can't give you them now, because otherwise it'd be as bad as last year. It's just a...
I understand that.
But that's exactly why we're here, that's the intention.
Is the thing here from the clubs that you want to know how much recreational sailing is doing? Don't you really mind?
I think we do need to know.
It's useful for the clubs to know, but it's as important for the funding authority to have that information available. Mm. The deal that we've got is that as a member of Grafham, it's be useful to know how many people just turn up and drink coffee sometimes.
Yeah, I think it is important.
Do you know, the data suggests that the cafe and having a Wi-Fi and all this stuff is really important.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And it's amazing.
Because it means that if there's no sailing on, you can do something.
Yeah.
It's a nice thing you should come to whenever it goes.
Yeah. And it encourages the community, you as the people to come.
If there's no sailing on, there's no other partner not here tonight for sailings, the simulation. You're also registered for that.
Well, what we're trying to do is build tools that will combine all the information. So you've got one system that can record everything.
Yeah, that's going to be, I perceive that may not, that may be non-trivial.
Well, we'll do our best.
Yeah. I mean, the question is, have you in the signing alliance, do you do things like access control systems and that sort of stuff, information at the moment, which you can feed into the main database?
We can integrate with access control systems.
Yeah. Not too difficult at all, actually. We have quite a good look at it.
Yeah. And the exciting thing about the computer world is that's all becoming open, well not open source, but open standards and communications.
Yeah. I'll debate that one, but that's a lot of debate. I'm very deep in the industry.
Yeah, but it's exciting, particularly with the web. I mean, we do things with hotels and booking systems that in the last 5 years, a lot of things have become open up, you know, which weren't just available, and the web does it. So
yeah, it's quite right. So it's a sharing, yeah. It's the capturing of information in one area, yeah, to share it, to use it in another area, that. Oh yes, you're a member of this club, so does vendor X want to buy this information to use it to promote something else, or cross pollination ideas, yeah.
The other challenge for me is that you can count lots of stuff, but whether you can actually add up the things you've counted to get to a useful total. So I'm thinking of things like, so memberships, you know, in Medusa we've got memberships and members, okay? So we've got one membership that happens to be, say, Kimbolton School, which is 40 junior members, and we've got another membership, which is Andy, right, who's a non-sailing member, but they both count as memberships. So if you say how many memberships have we got, that's actually just how many different addresses we've got, and that's the only commonality about them. You can't add them up and get to a particularly useful total, because they're apples and oranges, but at least they're all fruit.
That's a sort of definition issue.
So but that's what I'm saying. We can count lots of stuff, but unless you can add them up and get to a useful total.
Likewise
on members, we've got adult members who in our club actually pay quite a bit. We've got non-sailing partners who pay nothing. So our membership's up 10% and it's all non-sailing members. That tells you something different to our membership's up 10% and it's all adults.
But you can get that data.
So that's the best thing about Medusa is that we can get that data.
Yeah.
But I'm kind of a bit concerned about whether the totals actually mean very much. So when we do our responses to RYA, when they say, what's your membership done? It's up 6%.
Yeah.
But what sort of members? It's kind of the narrative that explains that. Yeah. That actually gives you the it qualifies the data, whereas just the raw data could be quite misleading.
Yeah, and I think that may be the thing that, you know, maybe the thing you guys can bring, which is, you know, to all intents and purposes, almost like a pre-populated form that prints out that provides a lot of that information counted up in the way that the RAA are actually looking for it, not our best guess.
So
and there will be some estimations in there and so maybe some blank fields.
Well, the end answer is, isn't it, first? And then cascading
backwards. But I mean, you guys can make it easy for us because you guys can code up all the analysis to produce the report rather than us going off with spreadsheets and, you know, people with various abilities on spreadsheets doing things slightly differently, taking them 3 weeks, half an hour, you know.
Yeah.
You guys can just create that report for us from at least on membership and some of the participation.
Yeah.
And that could really, you know, I think make life easier for most of the people in the room.
My concern is that if you're asked, so who are your important members? Are they the ones who are paying the most, the ones who are racing the most, the ones who are racing least, the ones who've only just arrived, or the ones who've been here for 30 years? You know, just depending on where you're looking from, they're important for different reasons.
Yeah.
Different clubs have a different view on that.
Yes,
they're all important.
Yeah, the important thing is the systems are flexible enough to let you record your memberships however you want.
Yeah, that's where Medusa has served us.
So well. You need to change the question, Peter.
No, right.
Change the question.
I mean, the answer to all this, you know, can you do this, can you do that, you know, really for us is yes. You know, we can gather all that data, we can crunch it however you like, really. In terms of the skills that we've got as a group and our ability to hire in, you know, manpower if we need it to do more work. The thing that's in the way, and the thing that these sort of sessions can be going, is, you know, we need the market penetration, basically. The more clubs that use the systems, you know, it's not just simply trying to drive more revenue for us, it's more clubs using the systems, the more consistency we can get back from what people want. And, you know, there's the more impetus there is to develop stuff. And as I showed in my first slide there, you know, we've got
good penetration, but we need to move on. So we're trying to do these workshops to see, is there a common requirement here? Yeah. Is there a common view? Can we drive this further and get everybody agreeing? I mean, obviously we are needful of leadership from our way of being clear about what it is we should be gathering, whether it's for your centralised returns or whether it's just your advice to the clubs. You really ought to know this about your members. You know, that'd be really useful stuff to us to be able to develop the systems. But really, the only obstacle is getting the volumes.
And you can ask lots of stuff, to be honest, that could challenge it. So I'd dearly love to know how long every club in the country their lease is due. And we ask that, and it winds people up because it's an hard question, because they have to do a lot of digging down. Bloody hell, we need to know.
That's some scary answers.
Genuinely, you need to know. So sometimes you've got to ask stuff that promotes a crikey
reaction.
Well, I mean, our membership systems could easily hold a few key business planning items. You know, that's a really interesting point. I'm going to write it down now.
It's pointless us talking about participation if your lease is going to expire in 3 years. That's what you need to focus on right now.
Well, the lease expired last year.
Okay, look, I'm mindful of the time here. I mean that was a really tremendous interactive session there, and I think what I got from it, there is real interest in us going ahead with this, putting together the systems we've got and starting to generate this dashboard. I mean that is really great to have got that.
It's backtracking a lot. You talked earlier about the cloud. Where is the cloud in this particular
What physically, where are our servers?
We buy into Medusa and all the rest of it.
Yeah.
And you talk about the cloud and the web. Is it your servers that we're using, or do we have to provide our own?
Well, all of us have different solutions for that, but typically we'll rent servers from the big high security, high reliability suppliers of servers, and we'll have them duplicated in different
replicated
places.
Replicated, yeah. So you don't, that's the beauty of most of our systems.
I have to ask the question, where's the data located? Where is the physical data and security of that data in those physical locations?
Our data is held by a company called Rackspace, who are in sort of Stockley Park, who sort of do a lot of military stuff and things like that. So we spend a fortune.
It's all in UK still.
Ours is Stockley Park, which is sort of just outside Heathrow. Yes, it's in
UK. Sorry? We use a UK data centre.
Yes, there's all sorts of laws about moving data.
Again, we're all taking that seriously and spending a lot of money on proper servers and proper companies and things like that. But our data's all home in the UK, I think. It sounds like everyone else's data's
home in the UK. Stuff for us with fast host. But the thing is, you've outsourced that problem to us. You know, we will comply with all the regulations.
Yeah, don't worry about it. Yeah.
We will make sure.
No, sorry.
There is a supplementary question.
Yeah.
Technology at Sailway. Can you save Sailway data to the cloud by just hitting a button?
Well, I mean, the easiest, and what I would recommend is probably when you're actually working on a file, is to put it into Dropbox. So it's the instant you actually save that file, and that's assuming you're online, your Dropbox will be synced to the cloud. Mm. So
it's the last thing I would want people down here to do is have to log in just to save today's results.
I mean, when I'm scoring an event, I always have my Sailway file in my as active in my Dropbox. So as soon as I hit save, that has actually then gone to Dropbox. And I mean,
a simple solution. People come here, use Sailway, but not totally intermediate.
Yeah.
Probably don't actually like PCs.
Right.
So all they want to do is stick the day's results in, hit the save button.
Yep.
Without too much fuss.
Yep.
Without them being prompted for anything, username, passwords, inside resignation, or anything like that.
As long as that PC's got is actually signed on with a Dropbox account, then that will happen.
It depends on the environment,
obviously, where you store stuff. I mean, the great thing about that, even the free version of Dropbox will actually store every iteration for the last 30 days. So if you save it at regular intervals and someone makes a mistake, you can go back to any one of those things that have been saved for the last 30 days. If you actually pay for your Dropbox account, then it's saved indefinitely. So you go back to every iteration of it indefinitely.
And even if you accidentally delete in Dropbox, they keep an archive for you. So it's